Good morning, y'all. Hope you're having a great day today. Welcome to My Life Movie. Today is a big day. We are preparing to take delivery of our llamas, and I have one more surprise. Tiffany just kind of got hit with this surprise earlier today. So, big surprise, like a big one. So we're here at our local feed store. We gotta get prepared for our livestock and grab a couple of things so they're nice and comfy. Okay, I thought these guys were chickens at first glance, but they're not. Can you guess what these are, babe?
Guineas.
Guineas, they're so cute. Hi, little guineas. You want a guinea kiss? guinea kiss? It is on my list to get some chickens really soon. Actually, I pre-ordered some and some ducks and a couple geese, but it's gonna be a couple months. Gotta wait closer to springtime. Yeah, and I wanted to guarantee I was gonna be getting like hens instead of like roosters. I did order one rooster, but that's all I want. I think I could just handle one rooster at a time. But these guys are adorable. They're so cute. I hear their eggs are very healthy. Okay, this is all new to me. I've never heard of giving animals mineral, but I guess they need the minerals, and this stuff is good for llamas too. All right, we need a couple of these big buckets. What should we get?
Well, being is that we have extra animals that I wasn't aware of, we need a lot of these.
Extra animals that we're not aware of?
Yeah.
Had a little small panic issue right now. So they just texted me and said that they're almost at the property. Oh, he just messaged me right now too. We got a lot of stuff, like a lot of stuff. The bed of my pickup truck is completely filled. Oh, they're there already. Oh. All right, babe. Guess what's in that right there? It's our little babies. I think they're gonna look at our farm and be like, these guys have nothing.
Yeah. I'm looking at our farm saying we have nothing.
So this is the entrance to our farm. All right, this is our paddock area. You got a 16-foot gate here. I mean, look how big this area is. And that is my chicken coop. I will show it to you in a little bit. Oh my goodness. Look at her.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh, she's adorable. Oh my goodness, look at these guys. You guys ready for your new home? Hi, baby. Oh my goodness, they're so cute. Are you scared? Don't be scared. You're gonna have so much fun here. So that's the boy back there, huh?
Yeah, the spotted one's the boy, and then this brown one, the friend, is the girl.
And there goes our other surprise back there. We got a Jersey cow.
Come on.
Ooh. Yay, there you go. Put that grass to good use. This is Logan right here from His Way Farm. That's the name of your farm, right?
Yep. His Way Farm and Exotics.
He's getting out the Jersey cow here. This is Randall.
There we go.
And, oh my gosh, look, she's ready to... Woo! She's so cute. Look at Hamlet. He's like, I got some buddies now. He's so excited.
Is that a turtle thing?
Where? It's a turtle or a tortoise hole. Heck, I don't know. That doesn't look like a gopher tortoise hole.
Rattlesnakes like to live in here. It goes way back.
It goes way back?
Yeah. It's all, I can see it all the way to at least here.
What?
Oh my God.
What the hell's in there? That does not look like a turtle hole.
No, because
could be a foxhole too.
A foxhole? Okay, put a couple pieces of wood here just to keep the animals from falling in that ginormous hole.
Oh, look at you. Hi, baby. Oh my God.
There she is.
Aw, she's adorable.
Oh, you're so soft.
Guys, hi.
Hi, baby.
Hi. Look, she's like, there's mama over there. Hamlet is so intrigued. Look at him. It's like, who are these guys? So we have this little enclosure here.
You're so cute.
What is that? So what's her name?
Macy.
She's liking the hay. What are you doing? Oh my God, it's so funny. It's just not working out for you. She's watching her parents leave.
Oh my God.
Oh, that's heartbreaking.
It's
She's
okay,
like,
Macy.
Where's mama going? It's She's
okay.
crying.
Oh my gosh.
We're going to give her so much love. Don't worry. Okay, I know it's going to take some time, but eventually my goal is to have these guys eating from our hands or even from like, you know, like a bucket or something. But yeah, this is their area. I have some stakes somewhere in the ground. Okay, yeah, that's where our barn is gonna go. And eventually I'll have like some more separated little enclosures for them. There are guardian llamas. They're gonna help guard the cattle. Oh God, some big old poopies on the ground already. They're gonna help guard our goats. And of course our chickens. They're a little
a little scared, but those guys came from a petting zoo, believe it or not.
Supposedly, people get tired of them after a little while at the petting zoo, and they want to see babies. So that's why I was able to get them, give them a forever home. And they will be here forever. Now, supposedly llamas, they do get parasites, a lot like goats. So we are going to have a vet checking up on them, maybe like monthly, making sure they're healthy and all.
Oh, look, it's getting curious. It's like, are you my friend? Now that is our chicken coop.
I had it custom made too because I wanted to make sure nothing can get from underneath. So I'm gonna show you the build here. It's awesome.
All right, fam, so this is our future house for our chickens. And this is like the nesting boxes. They're so cool, look at this. So much room and I got two nesting boxes.
I had a really nice coop before, but hey, I wanted to go all out and build something really nice. And I mean, this is it right here.
And like I was telling you, the bottom part is completely enclosed to avoid predators from like digging
up. And we got some guard llamas too, as well as a guardian dog that I will have in the next couple days. Now, the puppy that we're getting, it's a Great Pyrenees. They're specifically bred for that purpose, to guard livestock, and she's gonna help on the farm and she's gonna get a lot of love too. So it is gonna be an outdoor dog. Them dogs are just happier being outside. We want to give her a lot of love, introduce her to the other animals, but we do want to get her around the other livestock, the llamas and the cow. Could be a good time. But yeah, this is gonna be a perfect little spot right here for our llama, which Tiffany's naming her Macy. So I guess that's her name. We're leaning towards Mona for our Jersey cow. Her original purpose was to, like, I don't know if you want to call her a surrogate mother, but she was used to like feed some of the baby calves. She could still do that. Actually, she's still lactating, but I don't have any baby calves for her to mother right now. So we're just going to keep her just to keep her as a pet. And she could kind of graze the field here in the paddock and have a good time. Looks like she's already having a great time back there.
There she goes, right back there. I mean, I think she's having a nice time.
So, I mean, that's good to know if we get a calf in the next couple days, but more likely them chances are very slim to none. But yeah, in here, I'm probably just gonna move these perches out of the way just to give little baby Macy a protective area, just at least for nighttime. I might even put Piggy in here, Miss Piggy, with her. I do want them to kind of be raised together. Who knows? You know what? I might put the Great Pyrenees in here too.
The llama's just looking at me.
What you doing, buddy? You're so cute. You're so cute too. You guys need some names. Help me out here in the comments with some names.
In the next video, I'll, I guess, share their name if you guys throw out some good ones. But so far, we got Macy and Mona, which, by the way, we have to give Macy some milk. Don't have any milk for her, so we need to run to our local feed store.
Did you miss us? Look how alert she is. We got your milkies. You're gonna love it. What you doing?
Just feeding the baby.
Aw.
Where are you going?
She wants the whole thing. She's pretty thirsty.
Oh, sweet baby.
She was doing really good with the pellets. Oh yeah, she ate quite a bit.
So we're probably gonna have to bottle feed her for a couple more months. We could slowly introduce her to the other llamas, the bigger llamas, but right now they're just gonna be kind of like annoyed with her. Like, you know, look at this little kid, and they might kick her. So we gotta be really careful. She seems like she's doing really good on the hay and the feed, like the all stock.
Oh, she's drinking good. No, she still has some in here.
She's so cute. She's really friendly.
You want some more?
Aww. Give her a little nose kiss. Okay.
Got milk all over my nose. So Tiffany came up with a really good name for the boy llama. We're gonna name him Brock.
Oh my God.
Barack Obama.
just kidding.
We were looking up some names, and then of course, like, there's Dalai Lama. What was the other ones?
Angelama Jolie.
Angela.
And Selena Llama Gomez.
Oh my gosh.
I think they deserve some really good names.
Yeah.
Llamas supposedly don't like getting their heads touched. She likes this.
She likes having it behind her ears, yeah.
She's really young too. She's what, like a month and a half old?
So I'm sure I'm gonna get this question, like, Omar, what's the difference between a llama and an alpaca? Or alpaca. Well, first of all, llamas, the proper way to say llama is llama, because it originated in Southern America.
Wait, what's she doing? And they called them llamas, and in Spanish, the two L's make a Y sound, and llama means call in Spanish. So that's the proper way to say llama, is llama.
So alpacas are actually smaller. They look exactly, they're still in the camelid family, which she's related to a camel, believe it or not. She's so cute. If you didn't know, I mean, they look almost just like camels. They're like mini camels. But alpacas, they're pretty much, I believe they're related to the llamas. Yeah, they're camelids.
She ate a lot.
She did eat a lot. So she looks like an alpaca because alpacas are smaller.
And they probably get, I mean, they get a little bit bigger than that, but llamas are larger. They'll get almost like 6.5 feet tall. I mean, depending on how big they get.
My 2 and 3-year-olds that are in the back, the adults, they're about that high, pretty tall. Like, I mean, yeah, they're pretty tall. Alpacas, I believe they only get about that tall. So yeah, difference between llama and alpaca. Alpacas are smaller, llamas are bigger.
Some people even bring them inside their houses and potty train them.
You want to come inside? You want to come inside the house?
Getting a little worried. I do not see the llamas or Mona the cow. I do got to drive back there because I have quite a bit of stuff that I got for them. Also got to give them some water. There's my well right there. Eventually, I'm going to run some water lines so I have straight, you know, water back there. But yeah, I'm probably, I mean, I got a 300-foot water hose. I think that should make it. I mean, at least close enough. But anyways, let's get this well on. I hear the well. It is on. Okay. Whoa. Okay. All right. There we go. We're on now. Oh, I see Mona, but I don't see the llamas. Maybe they're underneath the tree. Nice weather for the llamas, by the way. I mean, it gets a little cold, but it's a work in progress, this whole farm thing. Okay, so this is Miss Piggy's little sister named Pepper, and she thinks she's a goat because the little baby goat she hangs out with, it's her best buddy. What's up, Phil?
What's up?
There's El Chapo. Yeah. So she eats grass just like El Chapo.
Oh, yeah. Eats grass the whole time. This thing eats grass.
Oh, she looks just like Miss Piggy. She legit thinks she's a goat. Eating grass. That is so
funny. And
she
pulls it out of the ground just like the goat. Instead of rooting it like she's supposed to.
Right.
She just rips it out of the ground just like the goat.
Look at her. That's so funny. So she just follows him?
Everywhere El Chapo goes.
Hey, El Chapo. How you doing? You're so cute. You are so cute.
Want to go see the llama, Chapo?
He looked at you all weird. Pepper, where are you going?
She'll follow him.
There she goes.
So you're getting
two
mad?
Babies.
Listen to her.
Two little babies.
Yeah, she gets pissed. When
hi, yo, Chapo. Hey, Pepper. She likes Pepper. Don't worry, you got a little sister pig too. She really does like El Chapo.
Aww,
look at that.
Look at them.
Aww. Oh, Chapo likes the food. Look at him.
He finally got to it.
Yeah.
Okay, I opened up the gate here. Hopefully it doesn't let Miss Macy out. Come on, get in there with El Chapo. You got it. You got it. Go in there. Come on. Ah, no.
Okay, so my camera died a little bit ago. Look what we have here. Day one. Eating right out of the bucket. And even better news, our cow, that's not really used to people so much, was eating right out of the bucket. You could tell that our friends from His Way Farm were taking really good care of these guys. Won't let me pet them a whole lot, but, you know, but they're still cool. And I haven't got spit on yet. Hi, buddy.
Keep doing that, you will.
That is Petunia, and that's Cheerio.
All right, so I guess they have names already.
Macy and Mona.
Hey, and check this out. We have a male and a female. Perhaps maybe one day they'll have some baby llamas.
They'll have some paterios.
Paterios! But yeah, the feeding stations are working out pretty good. I think it's a little tall for Petunia, but for the guy, he's pretty good. Got some water down there. Our hose made it till about right over there. We're about, I don't know, 20 feet away from the paddock, but it's close enough. She's doing really good around the big llamas too. Like, I thought the big llamas weren't going to be very fond of her, but I think she's doing really good, or they're doing really good with her. So let's go close to Mama Cow. She's coming. Look at her. I'm about to get attacked. Oh, wait, they don't like red, do they?
Yeah, they do. That's a myth.
Oh, I'm able to pet her. Look at this. This is amazing. Like, our future is very bright on the Safe Haven Ranch. By the way, that's the name of our ranch. It's gonna be called the Safe Haven Ranch. We're gonna rescue a lot of animals. That's what we're doing. Oh, look at her going. She took like 2 sips and there's like this much water missing. Swear. I mean, you know, she's a cow.
See all the shooting in the back?
Sounds like a damn war going on behind me.
So Miss Piggy's sister thinks she's a goat. Miss Piggy thinks she's a dog. Look, she's wagging her tail and everything. Tiffany said it looks like a windshield wiper.
So we came to bring Miss Piggy along to be introduced to the llama, which is gonna be great. Miss Piggy misses the ranch too. Right, Miss Piggy?
Yeah. Plus, we got a play date scheduled with you and Pepper.
We've been pretty much just leaving Miss Piggy out. She'll go in this little litter box she has there with some pine shavings. Pine shavings, I wouldn't recommend. We did get something else. They're like little pellets. That kind of makes a mess. But she goes in there completely potty trained. It's crazy. Like, you can train a pig, a baby pig at that, so much faster than a dog. They're very intelligent. I mean, we had a couple small accidents, like small Tootsie Roll accidents. But yeah, then she'll go in her little crate right there. We leave it open, and that's where she kind of snuggles herself to sleep.
There's Cookie. There's Luna. Love you guys.
Can't forget Mr. Little V, too. Hi, Little V. Want to give me a kiss? Want to give me a kiss? Hey, you're so cute. I promise, Little V says a lot more than just give me a kiss. Says a lot. But anytime he's just like loving on us, that's what he likes to say. Look all spoiled. Look at that.
All right, what's going on over here? I'm going to do a late night check on my babies. You can see that they're hanging out real close to the front here, which is great because I have baby in there.
I also put Miss Piggy inside there. I mean, she's all, you know, snuggled up in her little crate with all her blankets and stuff. And we did put a blanket in there for the baby llama. Yeah, they're doing really good. They're hanging out right here by the front gate, which is awesome. I did want to give the baby llama just some warm milk. Yeah, she's spoiled. Yeah. It is so unusually cold in Florida. I think some parts of Florida have even seen snow. No snow here, but definitely really cold. So I lost the little baby bottle. Is it in here?
No. There it is. Found it.
Hi, baby. Oh, you're so cute.
Let's check on Miss Piggy. All right, Miss Piggy's right here. And she's all snuggled up in her blanket.
I kind of feel bad leaving Miss Piggy out here. I wanted to give the baby like a friend to be with. And they've been doing really good together.
So look, this fit perfectly. Got that in there.
Got the bottles ready. I got one for Miss Piggy too, okay? Can't give the llama one and not Miss Piggy.
Miss Piggy, I got some milk for you. It's gonna get cold.
Ooh, some nice warm milk.
You don't want no milk?
I think I'm spoiling Macy a little too much. She's not really into this milk right now. I think she just wants to sleep. But you know who wants some milk?
Miss Piggy!
Yes, ma'am.
Miss Piggy wants to cuddle with Macy.
There's one thing about Miss Piggy is she loves blankets.
You got like 10 blankets over there. I am very new to having llamas as pets, but I will say I've done a great deal of research. They can live a long time, like 20 to 30 years. Get to grow old together. And even these guys, they're only a couple years old. I think the boy is 3 and the girl's 2. Hopefully in the future they'll kind of accept her, but this is a perfect balance to kind of have a separation because she's very small. It's gonna be a lot of amazing vlogs. I do got another surprise for you in the next video. I'm gonna go ahead and let you go. Before you leave though, give me a kiss. Mwah.